Okay, we're gonna, hey horse people, this is gonna be on a one rein riding what a horse. I get a lot of questions on one rein riding, and let me see if I can get on this horse, got no stirrup. So, this is my one rein riding with a rope halter. This is the reason why this is so important. I think I'll be able to do it better from to the side. It's too small with this horn here. This is key for, I'm gonna make sure that I'm on the, make sure you can see that good. This is what I want you to be watching right here. Okay, because this is what gives the horse, this is too big, so all I did was put this rope halter to hold it around its nose because it's too big. But basically, if this is around a horse's, this is a lead rope, I'm leading him, then I can get on him and I can ride him with one rein. Now, what does one rein teach you? I watch people ride and it's horrible about their hands. They hold the reins in two hands like this, and they're always doing this, and they're very, very lack around. I've told you, if you want to ride a horse good, you want to learn hand control soft, you've got to hold the reins in one hand and learn how to work and communicate with your horse with the other hand. So anytime I'm riding a horse, you're going to see me with reins in one hand. I'm going to be giving him a signal to go this way with this hand, and I'm going to let it go. If I want to go the other way, I'm going to switch hands. I'm going to pick up this rein, and I'm going to give him a signal to come to this hand. He's going to turn and move to this hand. And that's how I work a horse. Now, obviously, if I'm going down a hill or something, I need control, I'm going to shorten up on the reins and get a little bit closer down to the bottom. But what I don't want to do is have my hands way out here and back and forth and pulling and doing. When your hands are moving this much, you don't know what you're doing. Instead of moving my hands this much, I'm only moving the reins 4 or 5 inches maybe, 4 inches. I can put these reins in one hand, shorten this up, and now I've just moved it 2 inches. I've done the same thing. If I want to make it 4 inches, I'd slide that out, and now I have 4 inches. If I want to make it shorter, I go here. I can switch hands and go to this rein. I can pull here. I can make that longer and make it lighter. If I'm going down a hill, I can tighten it up and make this harder. The closer I get to the horse's head, the more control I have. So when you're way back here trying to control a horse, doesn't work. Reason why it doesn't work, try to turn this just a little bit. Reason why it doesn't work, you lose your strength. I want to be as close to the horse's head when I give him that signal if he's going to pull away. If I think a horse is going to pull, I get my hand lower. If I think he's going to listen, I can keep it high and keep it in this little 10-inch area to where right here. But this one rein riding is so important, and everybody, well, I want to put my horse out of a bit. Then ride in a round pen or in a closed small area with one rein. That is the only way you're going to build confidence to know that you can control your horse. Riding a horse one rein is scary. Most people are already scared of a horse anyway. Then you tell them to ride one rein, they're like, I'm crazy. They're scared because they need a bit. You got to have a bit to control a horse. I rode with a bit. They're out of control. They'll run off. They're going to flip. They're going to rear. They'll turn around. They'll bite me. You know, whatever. Your fear that you need a bit is self-induced. It has nothing to do with the horse. Most horses, I got a question the other day from this lady. She writes me, I've watched all your videos my horse, it does really good, but every time I try to give him direction and I ride him in a snaffle so I know it doesn't hurt him, but he throws his head up and he tries to rear and he swishes his tail and he kicks out and I don't know what's wrong. Can you help me? Yeah, I can help you. You're a dummy. You're so damn hard on the bit that you don't even realize you're hurting this horse. This horse is telling you the bit's uncomfortable, it hurts. You've got the bit too tight. Your hands are tight. You're scared. You're trying to give him some. This is too tight, people. This is tight. This is called connection on the bit. This is too. Now, I'll ride like this sometime, Mr. T, when he's excited to say, hey, slow down, so I maintain contact on his nose with this rope halter. But normally, I want to ride in a loose rein, so when I pick up this rein, it's easy to tell, hey, buddy, Mr. T, pay attention. Turn your head this way. Want to ride the other way, I throw it over his head, and I go, hey, turn your head this way. Turn your head this way. But the key to riding with one rein is you. It's not the horse. The horse can ride. He knows how to walk, trot, and canter. You're the one that feels out of control like this. But until you figure out that I hold this rein with one hand, and then I can ride my horse with just this one hand. Now, we can only do right circles, and I can only keep his head right, and I can stop him from running away by picking this up. But I have to be able to learn that one rein can control a horse. The reason why people can't ride one rein is because they're so used to having a damn bit that they got two reins and they're always doing this, thinking I gotta pull on two. I want a neck rein, that looks cool. I gotta hold my horse back. Oh no, he's gonna run away. I need two hands, two reins, two hands. That's you, that's your poor training. That's lack of confidence. That's lack of experience. That's lack of you training yourself on how to use one rein. You do not need two reins to control a horse. As a matter of fact, two reins make a horse throw his head more, rear more, pull more. A horse will never, I say never, some dummy will freaking videotape it because I'll make it. I can make a horse rear, but normally 99% of the time, horse will never rear one rein. Just won't do it because he turns his head sideways. He gets release. When he throws his head out, he pulls against one hand and he feels the pressure. So what, he turns his head? So what, he rears his head? So what? I don't care. It ain't no difference having one rein and two, except it's better for the horse and it's better for you. Learning to ride with one rein is critical to advance your horsemanship and your ability to ride. Until you do that, you're going to be these dumb riders in the arena that have two reins and they got to be on the bit and you got to have two hands and blah blah, and you're always in the horse's face and mouth and pulling and yanking and pulling. No, I'm scared. Oh, he's going to run off. Oh, my hands are quiet. Rick, look, I barely move them. They're quiet. You're an idiot. 99% of people don't have quiet hands. They don't even know what soft or quiet hands are. In their mind, they're soft because they don't have a bit in their mouth. But if I pulled on their face like they pulled on their horse's face, their attitude would change in about 2 seconds and say, you know what, that hurts. Maybe I'm not as soft as I think I am. Riding with one rein will teach you softness, finesse. It will teach you how to control your horse. It will build confidence. It will show you how lightly you can pick up this rein. You can use two fingers. You can use a whole hand if you have to. If you have to, you put two hands and pull. You want to use two hands so much? Use it on one rein. Because you can't do damage to the horse as much because the horse has a way to give. He knows. It's very clear what you want. The horse is getting one direction and one point of pressure. And he has one way to release. It makes it simple for the horse. The horse learns to give the pressure. When you're pulling on two, the horse learns to fight and pull and rear and get pain and does not know what you want because you don't know what you're doing. All the problems come back to you. I get so tired of people telling me, well, people are horse problems, and there ain't no horse problems, there's people problems. I was riding with a friend of mine a while back, and his horse wouldn't go down a ditch, and I just did a video on a ditch. His horse wouldn't go down a ditch, and he kept saying, he won't go, I've tried, I hit him, he won't listen, I need spurs. I said, you don't need spurs. So we switched horses. Now, I was riding Mr. T, and Mr. T, of course, went down all the ditches at a full run or jump hop. He don't care. He'll go anywhere. But this horse, as soon as we switched, guess what happened? The problem switched. Now, Mr. T would not go down a ditch, and this horse would go down a ditch. What changed? What changed was the riders. I got on the horse and gave better direction, better clear, better understanding. The horse knew what to do, and he went down the ditch. Mr. T had somebody on his back that was giving the same direction he was giving this horse that would do it, and Mr. T figured out, I don't have to go down hills. This guy can't make it. Now, the guy got Mr. T to go down, and he just had to, you know, really work at it, and it was hard, and Mr. T never tells me no, and he's ready to go everywhere. So to see Mr. T say no to a human was shocking, and I don't let a lot of people ride him. This guy happens to be my buddy, and I trust him with him, and, you know, we switched horses, and we rode, you know, on the way out, we rode our own horse. On the way back, we switched and rode each other's horse. So it gives Mr. T a little bit to see how other people ride. It gives me a chance to get on a new horse and a different horse, see if I can make that horse better. So, again, one rein is the key. If you can't ride with one rein comfortably, you're not going to advance. You're missing all the points to my videos. Your fear is still overriding what I'm saying. Because a lot of things that I say create fear. I try to get you to go over your fear. Riding horses ain't for the wimpy. If you want to be wimpy, then go buy a poodle and give him a doggy biscuit. Okay? I don't care. But if you want to ride a horse, it's risky, it's a big animal, and he's going to make you think. You cannot make a horse do what you can make your poodle do. You just can't do it. So, because the poodle, you're bigger, you're stronger, you're more dominant, it's easy to correct him, it's easy to stop him, the poodle's not going to kill you. All those are opposite with a horse. Unfortunately, you got a bunch of people out there buying horses thinking they're poodles, or thinking because they trained their hamster to run on a wheel that they can now somehow train a horse. It just doesn't work. Ride with one rein. This is very important. I get all kind of questions. I want to transfer my horse to a halter. I got a section on my website about it. I got all kind of writings, and I talk about riding with one rein and why it's important. And yet I still get all these questions. So stop all the questions. Stop. Get over your fear. Get over your I need a bit. Get in a small area where your horse can't run away, where you feel safe, and put him in a halter and ride with one rein. And at first, you're gonna be scared and you're gonna be snapping and pulling and leaning, and the horse is just gonna go in a circle because you're not gonna know how to relax and say, you know what, let me just see what he's gonna do without me interfering. Let me see what my horse does without my interference. And then if you relax, he'll relax. And then if you slowly try to say, hey, let's see if I can get him to turn lightly, he'll probably turn and give, and you'll be like, oh my God. That's when I get these emails when people try it. Rick, I rode a halter and it was so great, and my horse is so much better, and I'll never use a bit again. Well, that's good. But all those people had to take that first step to get out of their fear, to say, just because a horse has one rein, he's not gonna, if you can control a horse on the ground from running off and trampling and killing you with one rein, because that's what you do with a lead rope, you got one rein with a lead rope. Gee, Rick, my horse is better on the ground than when I get on his back. No shit, dummy. When you get on his back, you put a bit, pain, and you put two reins. Why don't you try doing what you do on the ground on his back? One rein, one direction, one cue, lack of confusion, lack of complication. You only have one rein. He only has one way to go. Makes it simple. Makes your horse better. Makes you better. Hope that helps, riding with one rein. Well, Lynette there. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.